Masi was a vibe. Masi. Masi was so many things. So many things. So near Sunday, Mono, Ekumunenga, and I issue. Maya Muadime, Tuombe, Miachon and Toto. My daughter is 8 years old. So, Mutuaka kwa maombienu na kwa abdomen, like kwa tumbo, you know. Na zilikuwa severe. She had to be admitted at Nairobi Hospital for some few days. And akaanza medication hapo. So, tumekuwa tukiendelea na medication wenyewe. Kama kuna madaktari hapa wanajua treating blood clots. Ni ugonjwa ina take time. Take time to treat. So she has been on medication for ile sana sana ilianza on December last year 2023 ikiisha. And three months down the line, Masi akajipata, she was expecting. And being expectant with her condition, it was always a risk. It was always a risk. And because there were more issues than just the blood clots, we had gone a period of about 8 years. So when Masi found she was expectant, she took the risk to keep the baby. And we went as far as we can to find the best doctors who gave us hope. Na wakatuambia, despite the, you know, the challenges, it was possible to carry the baby full term. But it was always going to be a lot of work. So we knew that from the beginning. So tume, in fact, tuliambiwa, when we crossed the third month, ni kama tumetoboa, because everything was looking good. For the past 5 months, because Masi's pregnancy was 5 months by the time of her demise, we've been in and out of hospital. Most of you ladies know that when you're expectant, you need to go to the clinic and you know, check the baby, check the mother. And at most, by the time of birth, the most number of ultrasound someone can have is about 2 or 3. But in a period of 5 months, we had done 16 ultrasound, because it was always a risky pregnancy. And Masi could go sometimes thrice a week to see the doctor. And every time we saw a doctor, the first thing is to check whether the baby is all right. And there's no two ways about it. So every time there had to be an ultrasound. Doctors in the house knows that treating blood clots entails using the blood thinners. And Masi's blood clots were unique because they were inside the body, because most of the time people with blood clots ujipata kwa miguu ama kwa mikono, and really inside the body, you know, but inside body parts. But Masi's, and they were severe, they are all over. If I could show you the scans, that were done, the CT scans, they were like all over the abdomen and the back part. So they were severe, and we used to take a lot of medicine. I even became a doctor because I used to be the one who used to inject her medicine every evening, akichoka kazi. So it's been a journey, but we always thought we were in control. The doctors give us hope every time, they were saying everything is okay. So until last Saturday, Masi woke up in good mood. She was supposed to attend a wedding of a dear friend. I don't know if she's here, but I'm fortune Mekali. And she even had dressed to go to the wedding. But I realized she was in pain. She was like forcing herself. And I talked her out of it. And it didn't take long before things went south, and it became an emergency. We had to go to the hospital. Fortunately, she was done an ultrasound, kama kawaida, and the baby was okay. But she was bleeding. And that was a big problem. So doctor took care of her. Unfortunately, we went home with her. So after that, Sunday was quiet, and Monday was the best day. That day, Masa didn't go to work, neither did I. Tulishinda tu kwa nyumba, in fact, tulishinda tu kwa bed on Monday. And everything, even the bleeding had, you know, stopped. Masa was not in pain. Everything looked okay. Until in the evening around 5 p.m., around 5 p.m., Masa woke up and vile tu alisimama akaniambia, I felt something strange. Nimesikia kitu inateremka kama mtoto anataka kutoka. There's something I hadn't said that I think was around 8 weeks. At 8 weeks, Masi had done something called McDonald's stitch. McDonald's stitch ni inafanyangwa na gynas. It's basically to
wanasika ambia watu wanyamaze huwa nyuma. Haya kwa kanjine baike andai telo andile tabadhali kembau kile banda ya nyamaze kwa kile duga hindi uyeo
ya kwata.
Tafadhali tunaomba kwa heshima. Hebu ukilewana yani amazi. Tunaomba utupe that minute ukiwa umetulia. Tutambua waheshimiwa na bwana yake Masi amalize. Na ende mwenge mdupe ukiliko kiroho za marais. Tumbo ukiliko kiroho mwanoe asa marais.
So Dr. Sedana McDonald's teaching to protect the baby from coming out. Basically ni kufunga cervix, kuzuia mtoto kushuka. So when Master told me amesikia like mtoto anashuka, akamuliza that's not possible because already we knew we had done that. As I was doubting, she told me imagine nasikia mimi mwenyewe najisikia. So we didn't take chance, we went back to the hospital again, and true, mtoto alikuwa anashuka. By the time we went to the hospital, hata miguu ya mtoto ilikuwa nje. So the baby had ruptured the uterus, And in fact, hapo amepitia hata kwa service. So it was that serious. So dakika dakika ni kupanga theater. And doctors, so many doctors came in. They were coming in one after another, one after another. And they had to remove the baby. And also the uterus. So it was painful. Mercy was very heartbroken when she got into the theater. And by the way, Mercy was walking by herself. She was talking, she was full of life. Only that things got complicated at the theater. And after the surgery, everything looked okay. And Mercy was supposed to be taken to the ICU. But before that could happen, Mercy got a cardiac arrest. And they tried to resuscitate her. But unfortunately, that is how Mercy left us. So I thought it was good to put that out there. And you see, people are wondering how people might be wondering how we are talking about having a bill in the hospital. That day alone, which was a marathon of about 12 hours, because Mercy spent 12 hours in theater, we got a big bill. There were many doctors, many specialists who came in to help the situation. Unfortunately, we had exhausted our insurance. As you know, when you're going in, inpatient gets exhausted. She had been admitted in January. So that is how we have a bill in the hospital. And that's why we were requesting for your help to clear the bill and also to give her a befitting send-off. Otherwise, nimuvea mono nikuka, Mercy would be very happy and wherever she is, if heavens have eyes, she can see how loved she is. Na kwa neasia akamba mwendo manguvu na ukamba ndikauma.
Yes.
Ukamba ndikauma. Yes. I came there and I became a member of you.
Yes.
So I feel as one of you. Na as much as Mercy hakujulikana sana kule kwetu Kikuyuni, those who in one way or another came into contact with her feel the loss, because Mercy was warm, Mercy was a vibe, Mercy was so many things. So ne asante mono eko monenga ndai yaisu mwe ya muadhime tuombee. Tumeachwa na mtoto, my daughter is 8 years old, so mtuweke kwa maombi yenu na Mungu awabariki. Asanteni sana.
Thank you, let us appreciate Mr. Mwangi kindly. Tuko nange Mwangi Makobi Masiona family Kalasinga. Yune enda kuonenge lele lingilea metuki. Nika na wili ya ishibiwa ni makuata mwana Musioba u. Kuu Kalasinga yu. Mwena kibela wa hand clappers Kenya.
Mwena kibela wa ajao?
Hand clappers.
Hand clappers.